More than a crocodile, a zebra may be just as strong, its hide almost as tough. If anything can give a croc a run for its money, it's a zebra. Even in high water, zebras are powerful swimmers. Dangerous kickers. The crocs turn out in force, but have no success. Some are nearly trampled. Once a croc's jaws clamp down, it takes enormous pressure to open them. But the zebra musters the strength to squirm free. Virtually unharmed. Still, crocodiles haven't outlived the dinosaurs by giving up easily. When a fall happens along, a croc manages to grab a leg. Rather than go quietly, the foal tries to bite through the crocodile's armor. One croc succeeds, the rest are quickly diverted from the hunt. One zebra, even a foal, is enough to feed several crocodiles. A herd of hundreds, plenty of resilient zebra, have survived to fight on. Soon, the wounded must run another gauntlet. Quickly as the zebra arrived, they depart. Such is life for large predators. Famine follows on the heels of feast. They're among the world's most successful killers. Their time-tested design, little changed for 60 million years, makes them fearsome adversaries of man or beast. Earth's most powerful predators, they can weigh a ton and grow over 18 feet in length. Driven by thirst, wildebeest must take an enormous gamble. Thank you. Crocodiles are stealthy predators, and they have time on their side. Their breath for hours. And in these waters, crocodiles are virtually invisible. Of a second, this giant can lunge more than 8 feet. But wildebeest have lightning reflexes. Leaving the crocs little but bruises and a bloody nose. The wildebeest are still thirsty, and the crocs still hungry. So long ago, most of Africa's waters had lost their crocodiles. Hunters had nearly wiped them out. But today, where crocodiles are protected, they're thriving. It's a remarkable recovery, considering that every crocodile begins its life facing extremely long odds. For a mother, the arduous struggle to raise a brood begins even before she has laid her eggs. In the first of many trials, she must secure a nesting spot free from flooding. Females return to the same sites year after year. Some veterans come back for decades. Here, as with all real estate, location is everything, and the best spots are hotly contested. A female shows off her size to intimidate her rival. Taking out territory is only the beginning. To avoid predators, a mother will often wait until nightfall to lay her eggs. It's vital she dig her nest correctly. The more secure the nest, the more babies will survive and thrive. She lay about 60 eggs. Even if female crocs do everything right, as many as half their eggs may not hatch. She encases them in sand to shield and incubate them. The cooler eggs will grow into females, while warmer ones will develop as males. Too hot or too cold, and none will survive. Her eggs are secure for now, but daybreak brings new challenges. Out here.